Hello and welcome back. Hope you are good, doing well. So we are having a Dollar CAD update here, but before going to look at that, if anyone want to join us or looking for training or trade setups, just simply head to thewavetrader.com. So here is the Dollar CAD. All right, so this was the previous video setup we were having on the Dollar CAD. We were expecting Dollar CAD to bounce back from the lows. All right, and this was the chart. Hopefully you have traded on that. It has nicely bounced back from these lows and went higher all the way up to the top. Let's look at this video analysis first. All right, and then we're gonna talk about what we can expect on the dollar CAD ahead of the non-farm payroll.
Floor, so let me find
when it was setting up for buy opportunity.
A chart. So this chart, all right, so we were expecting it to hold that floor. So the recent update
that
was that, right?
And expecting it to bounce back from the bottom.
In previous video analysis, we were expecting a price to break through that top, that flat formation, or fall back.
Those lows, setting up for buy
within this video analysis. So we were expecting it to break through that top and continue pushing more higher, or simply fall back from that flat formation for another time, and then go back up. Continue pushing more higher. So we got some strength on oil, which caused that dollar to go down against the CAD. Okay, otherwise dollar was gaining against the other risk currency. So what you're looking simply, once price, you know, tag these areas, these places, then you're looking price this trade, all right? This very much similar trade and a possible breakout for more upside and continuation to the upside. Okay, if you're not gonna get that
right, so
in case the price slightly goes back,
and we're gonna look at the next updated dollar CAD chart. So the next updated dollar CAD chart was there.
Hello, hope you're good, doing well. So,
right, so
we're having a dollar CAD update here.
Pause,
so let's look
sorry,
at the previous
forward,
video analysis so first, and then we're going to talk about what we can expect from
these
charts. Right, also telling me that the momentum is shifting away on this weekly time frame and on this daily time frame. Clearly can be seen that the momentum is shifting.
Momentum
is building.
The
price is setting up for a breakout. That's a longer term picture. Okay, we can stick to that. And I have explained, you know, in the previous video analysis on dollar CAD, that why we're expecting a dollar to rise against the CAD. We expect the CAD policy to reverse
back from the lows.
Bank of Canada reverse policy quicker than the Fed.
From
so what has happened over
the
lower time frame? We have,
just
if you are watching very closely, yes.
And this is the recent one. All right, let's go back. We get this bigger again. Bigger picture is still same. We're expecting that weekly, you know, weekly correction to break out. That hasn't changed much, all right? This hasn't changed much. This ABC move hasn't changed much, right? So that, you know, it can test these areas multiple times. There we can see, right, the bigger weekly correction. So we are looking that, as you guys know that, and continue to keep pushing more higher all the way up to the previous highs. If I'm gonna go to the lower time frame, all right. So we got a you know, non-farm payroll numbers. All right. So we got, I mean, bad report on both. Both reports were bad. The CAD was, you know, CAD labor report was, you know, far bad than the dollar one, okay, which caused that to continue to keep pushing more higher. I mean, a sideways market, sideways move over there. So if I'm going to make it, you know, again, simple and easy to understand that, what is the next move you are looking for, dollar CAD? Okay, this is the analysis. I mean, this is what you are looking. We still can see, guys, this move, so we cannot rule out that one more leg lower. Okay, make sure you understand that. So what we are looking right now, so you are looking simply price to hold the trend which is just emerged over there from the lows. Okay, we don't have a big news event at the moment except this inflation report. All right, so the inflation report is going to be, again, inflation is going to jump in the US. We may see strength on the dollar. Okay, this is the arrows are showing what you are looking for, right? The arrows are clearly showing what you're looking for. So if I'm gonna make it, yeah, that's what you're looking for, price to break these, you know, lower time frame corrections, 15 minute time frame corrections, and continue to keep pushing more higher, or another leg lower, hold these areas. Okay, hold these areas, hold these moving averages, and then continue. If we don't hold that and price visit all the way, again, we're gonna look for it to go back up. So not expecting this move at the moment, all right? But we cannot rule out that leg lower still on the dollar CAD. All right, that's what you're looking, guys. Thank you. Okay, so that was the previous dollar CAD setup. All right, so we were expecting a dollar CAD to rise from these lows and continue to keep pushing more higher all the way back to the high. So finally we got that move, and the next is that we are expecting it to just reverse from that top. Okay, we are not expecting it to break through that that top and continue to keep pushing more higher. So we are expecting another leg lower all the way back to the bottom. So that's very likely, and it seems that has already begun. I'm gonna look at the wedge. All right, so it was just setting up for breakdown from that high, and finally started to drag lower. Okay, so now we can see that it's going down, yeah, from that high. And there we can see, so and breaking lower, there we can see that on this updated chart. Okay, so there is the 1 hour time frame correction, which is just setting up over there for another breakdown. So it's the correction is simply setting up over there ahead of the non-farm payroll, and you are looking simply bad numbers on NFP and this to break down and continue to keep drag lower. So if we don't get that bad numbers on NFP, right, then simply push for another leg higher, retest of those top or new high, and then again keep dragging lower. Okay, if I'm gonna look at the updated chart now, price is just trying to break through that flag right now, because the data is just released over there, the PCE data released and unemployment claim data is just released. Okay, and it's just simply trying to break down and continue to keep dragging lower. There we can see that you're looking for this to break down and continue to keep dragging lower, so you can get into the breakout. I wouldn't suggest you to chase that breakout. All right, I don't see that it is going to continue before the non-farm payroll. All right, and if you want to get, I mean, if you want to sell it, then let the price, you know, form new highs within that flag, and then you are chasing this from these highs or within the moving average in these areas. Okay, and then looking for breakdown. In case if it doesn't, yeah, and this breakout which is just trying to appear over there is going to continue, you only can get into that breakout if the breakout is going to be really, really aggressive and extreme. All right, then you can get in. Otherwise, let this flag to, you know, test those moving averages, hold and break down, or revisit those highs and then start falling. Hope that makes sense and you got the idea that what you are looking. Okay, this flag which is just appearing over there, stay below that, I mean that flag, to stay below those moving averages and continue to keep falling. Yeah, if that flag, you know, does not break down and go but another leg higher, okay, then you're looking it to hold those highs and then continue. If I'm gonna, you know, these places you're watching are dollar cat, where you can see my blue lines or breakdown, whatever comes first. Okay, thank you.